Welcome back to Earth from Space. Today, Copernicus Sentinel-2 takes us over Kiruna, the northernmost town in Sweden. Visible in darker tones, Kiruna is located in the county of Norrbotten and is around 145 kilometers north of the Arctic Circle. The city, with a population of around 22,000 inhabitants, is on the eastern shore of Lake Lussejärvi, between the iron ore Kiruna and Lussevara mountains. Around 20 kilometers east of Kiruna, the small town of Jukkasjärvi is visible and is best known for its annual ice hotel constructed from snow and ice blocks taken from the nearby Torne River. Thin dark lines cutting across the image are roads that connect the towns with other parts of Sweden. At a latitude of almost 68 degrees, around 40 kilometers east of Kiruna, lies ESA's Kiruna ground station, which in September 2020 celebrated 30 years of space excellence. Kiruna ground station is part of the agency's tracking station network, a worldwide network linking satellites in orbit and across the solar system with ESA's Space Operations Center, ESOC, in Darmstadt, Germany. Ideally positioned to support polar orbiting missions, the station is a crucial gateway for much of the data enabling us to study our planet's oceans, water and atmosphere, forecast weather and understand the rapid advance of climate change. The station features two sophisticated terminals with 15-meter and 13-meter diameter antennas to communicate with satellites in Earth's orbit, such as Aeolus, Swarm, Cryosat and the Copernicus Sentinels, including the recently launched Copernicus Sentinel-6 Michael Freilich satellite. While the North Pole Satellite Station in Alaska caught the spacecraft's first signals from space after separation from the launcher, the Kiruna ground station tracked the satellite's first days. EUMETSAT then completed the final orbit acquisition, taking over responsibility for commissioning, routine operations and distribution of the mission's vital data. While Sentinel-6 is one of the European Union's family of Copernicus missions, its implementation is the result of the unique collaboration between ESA, NASA, EUMETSAT and NOAA, with contribution from the French space agency CNES.